Transactions may take on many different forms. We should therefore systematically distinguish between the various characteristics of transactions. This will assist us with the proper identification and classification of transactions in the various macroeconomic statistics accounts. The most common form of transactions are monetary transactions. However, since macroeconomic statistics aim to capture all economic events and activities, we should also include transactions that are not in monetary terms. In other words, non-monetary transactions. Let's start with monetary transactions. All flows in macroeconomic statistics are recorded in monetary terms. However, the distinguishing characteristics of a monetary transaction is that the parties involved in the transaction express their agreement in monetary terms. All monetary transactions are interactions between institutional units. That is, all monetary transactions are at least between two or more parties. Common monetary transactions are, for example, expenditure on goods and services for consumption, the acquisition of a security, wages and salaries of employees, interest, dividends and rent, taxes, and social assistance benefits payable in cash. Non-monetary transactions, on the other hand, are not initially stated in units of currency. These transactions can be two-party or internal transactions. Examples of two-party non-monetary transactions are barter transactions, where two units exchange goods, services, or assets other than cash of equal value, for example, a cow for a horse. In-kind transactions, such as remuneration in kind or other payments in kind. Remuneration in kind is where an employee is compensated with goods, services, or assets other than money. Other payments in kind occur when a wide variety of payments are made in the form of goods, services, or assets other than money. Transfers in kind are a specific payment in kind, usually made to increase or ensure the intended goods or services are consumed. For example, aid after a natural disaster may be more effective when provided in the form of medicine, food, and shelter instead of money. Internal transactions occur when a single institutional unit acts in two different capacities, and it's analytically useful to record this act as a transaction. The most common example of an internal transaction is what we call consumption of fixed capital. This entry can be viewed as the macroeconomic version of the depreciation of assets. In this case, the economic owner of the assets act in two capacities, as the owner and the user of the assets. We have seen that both monetary and non-monetary transactions can be exchanges or transfers. Put simply, exchanges are something for something, or requited, and transfers are something for nothing, or unrequited. In addition, transfers can also arise when the value provided in return for an item is not economically significant or is much below the value. An example of an exchange is where an employee provides their labor to an employer in exchange for an asset, their salary. Another example is the sale of a car. One unit provides an asset, the car, in exchange for another asset, cash. An example of a transfer is where someone pays a tax to government. The taxpayer does not get anything directly in return for that tax payment. Social assistance benefits paid by government to households are further examples of transfers. Subsidies to corporations are also transfers. Transfers can be current or capital. This distinction is important because their economic impact and nature are different. It is also important for calculating saving and other macroeconomic aggregates and balances. The various characteristics of transactions allow us to identify and classify them according to their appropriate economic nature in the macroeconomic statistics accounts.